This video explains pneumatic circuit used in metering application. So first we'll draw the circuit diagram for this particular metering application. Now as you can see over here, there are various components which are involved in this particular circuit. They are nothing but what? The FRL unit. Then you are having the direction control valve, then double acting cylinder, and the flow control valve. So let us start with our first component, that is FRL unit. So it is filter, regulator and lubricator unit. Then we are having this direction control valve, and it is push button operated and spring offset or spring control. Then there are four ways, P, R, 1 and 2. These are the four ways. And there are two positions, that is the left envelope mode. So this is our left envelope mode and this is our right envelope mode. So there are, so it is a four-way two position direction control valve. Then we are having the flow control valve, as you can see over here, with the restricted opening, and it can be variable also as shown by this particular arrow, and it is integral with the check valve as shown over here. This arrow indicates that it is the pressure compensated and this is the temperature compensated. So it is pressure and temperature compensated flow control valve with the integral check valve. Now this is the double acting cylinder. Air can be admitted from both the sides and therefore it is known as double acting cylinder. So air from compressor, it enters into this FRL unit, will get filtered, regulated and lubricated, and then it enters into this particular left envelope mode, that is port P. From P it enters to 1. Then it cannot go from this side because this is the no free flow condition for the check valve, and therefore it has to pass through this particular restricted opening, and therefore the control rate of air is achieved, and therefore this particular air, as it is coming inside the cylinder at the control rate, therefore the forward motion of this piston along with this piston rod will be slow, and as the air which is entering inside the cylinder is controlled, therefore it is known as metering application. The air from the other side can easily go from 4 to 2 and from 2 to R, that is nothing but the atmosphere. So this is the next position of the piston and piston rod. Now when we are having, when we operate this push button in such a way that we'll get the right envelope mode, then let us see what will happen. Again, air from compressor, it enters into FRL unit, correct, and now it will enter into port P. Now we are in the right envelope mode. From P it will enter 2 and from 2 to 4, and it will cause this particular piston to retract inside the cylinder. The air from the other side can easily go through this particular check valve because it is a free flow condition, correct? So there is no restriction, as well as it can easily pass through this particular the flow control valve also. And then from 1 it will go to the R, that is nothing but the atmosphere. So in this way the pneumatic circuit is used in metering applications.